Good morning, everyone. Today I am here to discuss about the industrial gardens. So here two terms, industry plus garden. So garden, with the help of ornamental plants, beautification of surroundings is known as gardens. Or we can say garden is a place. So there we can plant the beautiful trees, herbs, vines, climbers, seasonal plants, and also the some other hardscapes, so that one, with the help of beautiful fauna, they can add the beauty. So that place is known as garden. And industry is the place there manufacturing unit, or we can say the industry is a manufacturing unit. There we can produce the or manufacture the different kinds of products, like steel factory, cement factory, or maybe medicinal fertilizer units, fruit processing units, various kinds. So especially we can see the for cement factories, steel factories, etc., they can release the lot of harmful gases, that is create the pollution problem in the environment, and also the in some factories creating the noise, in some factories is dust problem, or maybe in some factories are releasing the polluted waters. So they create the lot of problems. So we can say the people, they work in the industries, and also the their family and children, they live in the industrial townships, and the workers, other staff, so they need these some beautiful environment for relax, so they can improve their working efficiency. So that is the objective to develop the industrial gardens. So what is the purpose of industrial gardens? These gardens are designed to check pollution and also to beautify the area. So two main purpose of industrial gardens. Number one, to check the pollution. What kind of pollution? So our objective to check the pollution, and also to beautify the area. The majority of industrial units are surrounded by weeds, debris, and unkempt areas. So these units are the main source of air pollution, water pollution, noise pollution, and we can say the dust pollution. So other than the checking the pollution and beauty, if we are developing the industrial gardens in surrounding areas of industries or factories, so cleanness of that area, and also the due to beautification or greenery or beautiful flowers, workers can feel relaxed in that area. So the objectives of industrial gardens. So the objectives of landscape planners are beautification of factories and industrial townships, to create a better environment for living, working, recreation, and circulation रॉक गार्डन. सो ये वेल लैंडस्केप्ड इंडस्ट्रियल प्लांट्स कैन बी वेरी अट्रैक्टिव. गार्डनिंग इन द अराउंड फैक्ट्रीज आर नीडेड टू फाइट पोल्यूशन एंड डस्ट बिसाइड्स ब्यूटिफिकेशन. So in landscaped industrial plants can be very attractive. So we can say the ornamental plants, we can't put all plants anywhere. So it is better if we are developing the industrial gardens, then we should prepare the landscape plan. Then we have to put right plant at right place. So it can be very attractive. And gardening in and around factories are needed to fight pollution and dust besides beautification. So factories may be broadly categorized into two groups. The first group comprises comparatively neat factories such as fruit processing plant, which emit less dust and other polluting materials. So we can say in fruit processing plants, we manufacture like fruit juices, nectars, RTS, that is ready to serve, cordials, squashes, jam, jelly, ketchup, fruit toppings, etc. So in these first group factories, no major pollutions occurs. So we can say first group factories are safe, or we can say less polluting. And in the second group consists of factories such as cement, steel, fertilizer, etc., which emit a lot of dust, smoke, and harmful chemicals. So second group factories are too harmful. And we can see the developing of industrial gardens in surrounding areas of cement factories, steel factories, fertilizer factories. So due to emitting the lot of dust, smoke, and harmful chemicals, it is very challenging to develop industrial gardens in group second. So the features of industrial gardens for the factories of first group, a wider range of plant material can be used. Because first group factories are less polluting, no release of harmful chemicals. So in first group factories for developing the industrial gardens, we can select the large number of plants from wide range of plant materials. And for factories belonging to second category comparatively is releasing harmful gases, harmful chemicals, noise, dust, etc. So that is very challenging. So that's why we have to select only hardy plants. And in terms of the selection of hardy plants, so that we have this short list for that. Planting is done in the industrial gardens to arrest the drifting dust and cut down of noise. So we can say in the industrial gardens, for example, one side is the industry, another side the industrial township, or we can say the residential stock quarters. So in between of both, we can grow the tall, dense canopy plants. So that can create the barrier, and at certain limit, they can reduce the noise, or we can say drifting of dust, and also the pollution issues too. So these suitable plants for industrial gardens are suitable plants to cut down this type of pollution are Eucalyptus citriodora. So this one is the tall vertical growing plant, so we can grow in the dense canopy. So at least from that much height, the harmful gases can go up and we can protect the pupils that reside in the industrial township. And Ficus religiosa, Ficus benjamina, and so on. So Ficus religiosa is people, and Ficus benjamina, they are the highest oxygen generator plants. So it is very useful, these plants. We can grow in the industrial gardens. The planting of trees in industrial gardens. So a large number of such trees are to be planted, either in groups, clumps, or in multiple rows, which will enhance beauty, provide shade, and regulate the environment. So we can say these plants, if you are growing surrounding areas of industrial gardens, so they can solve the different purposes. In number one, enhance the beauty of surrounding areas, and also provide the shade. We can say the avenue trees. So if you are growing the tall dense canopy trees, so during the rest period or other times, workers can sit under the trees. So due to the transpiration, they can create, plants can create the cooling effects. And also the no doubt in this, by the photosynthesis process, other than the manufacturing of food material from the raw material of water and carbon dioxide, green trees can also release the oxygen, and that is very useful for our respiration, and regulate the environment. So no doubt in regulation of the surrounding environments. Industrial township consists of factory sites, various types of public buildings, industrial buildings, community centers, and residential complexes. So in various types of public buildings, for example, electricity office, water supply office, or maybe banks, schools, post office, etc. These type of public buildings also in the industrial areas. And industrial buildings, so maybe any industrial development offices to community centers or residential complexes means the industrial staff can reside there, their families, etc. So obviously they also need the community centers like gymnasiums or for social activities, festivals, marriage ceremonies, etc. So the features considered in industrial garden designing. For a landscape designer, there is a ample scope to implement his aesthetic ideas in such units. Different areas are to be improved by providing streets, sidewalks, parking, sewers, and sanitation. So these areas are to be improved, providing streets, sidewalks. So we can say the both side of the driveways, we have the sidewalks, walkways. So that area we can improve. Parking places and sewer lines, sanitation areas, etc. Installation of public utilities such as water, electricity, gas, and other convenience. The features considered in industrial gardens designing. Between the factory and residential areas, green belts may be created by planting trees. So in this one, we can grow the tall, dense canopy trees. So they can create the green belts. So we can say the screening factory area is one side and residential area is the other side. So trees, land, streets, well-kept parks, gardens, playgrounds and woodlands should be permanent features in industrial trees. So the industrial gardens are designed mainly to check option A, stealing, option B, hiding ugly spots, option C, pollution, and option D, none of these. So correct answer is option C, that is pollution. Next question, the purpose of industrial gardens are option A, control pollution, option B, to beautify the area, and option C, for better environment, and option D, all of these. So we can say the purpose of industrial gardens are all. Industrial gardens also control the pollution, beautify the surrounding areas, and also create the better environment. Next question, the majority of industrial units are surrounded by weeds, debris, and unkempt areas. And these units are the main source of. So in this question, option A, air pollution, option B, water pollution, option C, noise pollution, and option D, all of these. So in these, correct answer is all of these. Air pollution, water pollution, and noise pollution. Next question, beautification of factories and industrial townships to create are the objectives of landscape planners. So in this question, option A, better environment for workers, option B, recreation for workers, and option C, both of these, and option D, none of these. So in this one is correct answer, both of these. It creates the better environment for workers and also recreation for workers. Master, good morning. कौन से सेमेस्टर का? ठीक है सर, मैं भेजता हूँ अभी. अभी तो सेकंड सेम चल रहा है. ठीक है सर, मैं भेजता हूँ. सर वैसे तो अब तो जुलाई तो शुरू हो गया, बाकी अभी तो किसी यूनिवर्सिटी में शुरू नहीं हुआ. शायद इसका जो प्री पीजी कब, 8 अगस्त को है, कब है? अब ये तो सर अपना तो कुछ नहीं है, अपना तो वो कंडीशन है ही नहीं कि प्री पीजी से ही लेंगे हम. एमएससी में तो हम किसी को भी ले सकते हैं. एक तो वो लड़की है, और कौन आ गया? अच्छा, तो उसका भी बनाना है क्या? हाँ सर. अच्छा सर, हाँ तो ये तो मैं आप ही भेज रहा हूँ सर. पर सर इसमें जो हमारे जो है ना, इसके जैसे क्रेडिट सेमिनार है, कॉम्प्रेंसिव है, और ये मास्टर्स रिसर्च है, वो तो उसमें डाल ही नहीं रखा. सर ये तो आ रहा है, ये 1 मिनट में आ जाएगा आपके पास. Thank you. Hey, good morning. Yeah, this is Dr. Rajendra Maurya. Today, I am going to deliver a lecture on institutional gardens. So basically about gardens, you know well, by using the available flora, we can beautify the surroundings. So in this one, we can use the both hardscape and softscapes. So you know, hardscapes like the boundary wall, buildings, parking area, lanterns, fountains, running water, ponds, ports, trees, carved stones, walkways, driveways, and many more. Or in terms of the softscape, we are using the plant material like trees, shrubs, herbs, vines and climbers, annuals, meaning the seasonal plants, for beautification of that plant. So especially in case of the institutional gardens, institute, you know, universities, colleges, schools, so any educational institute or training centers, etc., we want to beautify that with the ornamental plants. So ornamental plants that have the aesthetic value. So if those institutes we beautify with the help of the ornamental plant, that is the institutional gardens. So in institutional gardens, the institution includes both public and private institutions, like hospitals, government and private offices, courts, auditorium, cinema halls, hotels, and so on. And if we are taking the example for universities, then private universities as well as the government universities, etc. So in those places, we would like to beautify it. Then other than the building of that institute, by using these some ornamental plants, trees, shrubs, vines and climbers, some pot plants, or in beds, we can use these some seasonal plants or annuals, and we can beautify that particular place. So public buildings are often expected to be formal, even and monumental in their design and setting, and they require special aesthetic treatments. So we can say, especially for public buildings, we can develop or we expect to develop in the formal style. In formal style, we generally develop in the symmetric manner, okay, geometric point of view. So proper placement and arrangement of institutional buildings are gaining importance in the modern world. It is now realized that an institutional building is not complete until the walks, drives, lawns, and recreational areas are properly developed in the compound. So we can say in any institute, hotels, or any other offices, the main recreational point is the walkways, driveways, lawns, and other features of gardens we develop. So the modern method requires a large area of ground. In modern methods requires a large area of ground for proper landscape development. So I mean, if we have the large area, then we can openly beautify that landscape. Or in case of the small scale area, we have the limited options. So in large areas, we have multiple options. So we can beautify without any problem. Hello. 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 For landscape development, open area can be dividing into two well-defined areas. First, the portion of the ground adjacent to the building, and second, the remainder of the area, usually at the rear of the building, should be developed for recreation. So we can say the approaching, or we can say the adjacent area of the building, we have to develop first. That should be for recreation, and the remaining open area we can develop later stage. So in the first area, that of public portion of the ground, so the driveways, walkways should be primarily structured in order to give quick access from the points of approach to the entrance of the building. Planting treatment of the institutional ground should be simple. So planting of ornamental plants or planting treatment of institutional garden. So on the ground, it should be simple. The institutional building is usually large, and hence it is better to lay. Hello. Jaya. So the institutional building is usually large, and hence it is better to rely upon a fewer number of specimens of sufficient size to establish a proper relation between the planting and the type of building. So I mean the in institutional garden nearby the building. So building, that is the hardscape, and for beautification of that building or surrounding areas, we are using the ornamental plants. So during the planting of ornamental plants in nearby building, so it should be have proper relationship between planting and the building. So selection of trees and their location should depend upon the architectural style of the building and by the requirement of shapes. So you know the building, that is the permanent structure, and nearby area we want to plant the trees, shrubs, vines, etc. So before selection of these plants, we should consider the shape and design of that building, and we must know the what is the form of that trees, what is the growth habit of that. So based on that, we have to select and plant trees and shrubs with fruits and nuts or with dangerous thorns should not be used. So we can see the institutional gardens, we are planting the trees and shrubs. So especially fruit plants, or we can see the nut plants. So we can see the those trees and shrubs, they bear the edible fruits we never consider, and also if those plants have the thorns, those also we have to avoid, never consider fruiting plants as well as the thorny plants. So development of the recreational area is very important in institutional plant. So recreational area is very important part in institutional planning. The recreation area is generally kept at the back of the building, or if sufficient area exists by the side of the building, this can also be utilized for the purpose. Recreation areas are planted with trees after careful consideration. So in careful consideration, I told you what specific features we have to consider just before we mentioned the fruit plants or thorn plants, never consider. And also one more important thing, that we avoid plants, fragile plants. Fragile means the those plants, they are easily breakable. So these type plants we have to avoid. And also never plant the trees, those trees they have the shallow root system, because during these storms or heavy winds, those trees have chances to fall down. So use of shade trees is restricted to the borders of the area, away from the land used for game courts and the athletic fields. For a playground, however, it is advisable to plant shade trees so that the games equipment can be set up the shade. In the recreation area, the use of cement or bricks is inadvisable due to injuries it could cause during active games. So I mean, the if you are using the any cemented materials or cement, bricks, stones, etc., we should avoid, because during the active games it can injure the players as well as the children, etc. The lawn area should be planted with hardy grasses. So if you are using the hardy grasses, it will require the less maintenance and easily established. If you are using the sophisticated grasses that require the frequent watering, regular mowing, and so many other things, if in case of the poor maintenance, it will create the problem, and it instead of the beauty, that will create the ugly looking. So in order or enhance the beauty and attractiveness of the building, certain areas can have the best lawns, seasonal flowers, bulbous plants, rare and pretty shrubs, arches, pergolas covered with climbers. So we can say in the for beauty and attractiveness of the institutional gardens, we can use these best lawn and seasonal flowers and annuals like petunia, zinnia, phlox, sweet sultan, pansy, and sweet williams, larkspur, and many more. Okay, and bulbous plants like lily, gladiolus, tuberose, etc., narcissus, etc., and pretty shrubs. Also, we can develop the arches, pergolas, etc., by using the beautiful vines or climbers. So the library building, health centers, canteens, all must have proper settings, service, and approaches. So in each situation and pocket poses problems and brings different requirements, but they can be solved by applying the principles of good landscape design. So landscape for educational institutions, the compounds around educational institutes are generally neglected. An ideal school ground plan could create a spacious and extensively planted park. So we can see the in school ground, colleges, universities, this should create a spacious and extensively planted parks, planted with the trees, shrubs, and other ornamental plants too. So and landscaping not only enhances beauty and appearance, but also inculcates aesthetic sense to younger generations. Thus, it becomes necessary to landscape the campuses of educational institutes. It is better to have a master plan of the whole area and to implement it in phases according to the resources available. So I mean, the during the development or during the construction work, or we can say just before, if we are planning for the any educational institutes. So during that time, when we will prepare the master plan, so same time, other than the hardscapes, we should give the emphasis for soft scape development like lawns, trees, shrubs, hedge, etc. So this is the very important. So planting we can do in the phases according to resources available. So it is not necessary we can develop the whole area at a time. We can do in phases. So landscaped area might provide adequate room for free play and supervised recreation, sports events, and outdoor ceremonies. So this one is also important. So that area also we can beautify. So the main aim of the landscaping educational institutions is to control noise, storms, and dust, and to provide shade and screen some ugly place with the help of the plants. So I mean, during the landscaping of educational institutions, by using the plants, we can hide the some ugly places, and also by using of these tree shrubs and other ornamental plants, objective is to control the noise pollution and also reduce the storms and also the dust pollution too. So these we can say the landscaping plants can solve the various issues. So other than the noise pollution, also purify the air, so that can provide the healthy environment. Okay, and even in unplanned school buildings, it is possible to improve the landscape by careful planting. Okay. So a school garden should be planned with plant materials which need minimum of maintenance, because in the schools we don't have the sufficient staff to maintain these plants. So it is better we can select the plants that require the minimum maintenance. In the periphery of the school campus, along the rear and wings, a thick belt of large shady trees should be planted to bring down noise and cut down dust and storms. During the trees, this one is also important parameter to consider, and that can work as a shelter belt. So that will reduce the noise and also storms, and other than these also purify the environment and provide the good amount of oxygen. So the plantation will help keep down severe heat and cold. So we can say during the summer, plants, trees, shrubs, etc. will transpire, and that can create the cooling effect. Or in case of the winter, it can also cut down the cold effect and increase the heat. So for enhancing the scenic beauty, it is suggested to plant a row of flowering trees with different bloom. Of whole beauty of those institutional gardens, and thickly planted belt of eucalyptus, silver oak, and so on is also very suitable for peripheral planting. So silver oak and eucalyptus is also good examples. So out of these, silver oak is lovely plant that will give the nice foliage beauty as well as bears the beautiful flowers. So the front should be planted with medium sized flowering trees for beauty, and the trees should not completely obstruct the view of building from outside. It means if we are growing the too tall trees, that will hide the view of main building. So we have to select the plants accordingly, and also the by training pruning we can maintain the same size of those trees. The roads and paths are to be formally planted with medium to tall flowering plants. The provision should be made of overhead wiring and sieveage before even planting, so that these do not interfere with it. Then shrubs play an important part in the school landscaping. Shrubs, because in shrubs we have the large group of plants, so easily we can select, and that is the dwarf in nature, so we can enjoy the more beauty. Okay, so border planting of shrubbery on large grounds or at the back of the school campus serves useful purpose of filling the gaps between the trees and lawns. So we can say the in between the lawns and tall trees we can use the shrubs to enhance the beauty. So moreover, small paths can be planted with shrubs arranged in formal beds or rows, thus improving the beauty of the paths. Shrub border around playgrounds require minimum maintenance and is effective than hedge. So we can see the as compared to hedge, shrubby plants or shrubby borders require the minimum maintenance. Okay, so that should be effective than hedges. Ye hedge needs regular trimming. Shrubs with suitable colorful flowers are more colorful than hedges. In hedges mostly only foliage beauty, but problem is requires more maintenance as compared to shrubs. So the foundation planting can also be undertaken with evergreen dwarf and trailing shrubs. So flower beds, especially with seasonal ones, should not be preferred. A lawn looks nice in an educational institute, but it is difficult to maintain. Yes, no doubt lawn is difficult to maintain, but it is very important part for the educational institutions. A bougainvillea creeper trained over the wall of the building can change the whole look of building. So garden ornaments like a bird bath provided amidst the trees will attract many birds, which will be educative to the students as well as also add the beauty. So different trees, shrubs, flowering animals, etc. may also be properly labeled to enable students learn their names and develop knowledge. So this one is also educational to students. So we can say a type of botanical garden we can develop on the campus. So this was the beautiful presentation on the institutional gardens. I hope all of you enjoyed it.